Hello, in this video I want to show you how to make corrections easily in 3ds Max. Now sometimes you import FBS file from Revit or SketchUp and all of a sudden you've forgotten to correct something. Maybe there's something that was omitted, or you decide to you want to create a new model part. So this is what this video will show you. Now there are two ways you can go about it. If you know how to model in 3ds Max and what you have to model is not much, then you can simply model it in 3ds Max. But if you don't know how to model in 3ds Max, then you can go back to your Revit, you work on it, and you are going to bring it in here. Only that part that you corrected is what you are going to bring in here. So you will not have to start afresh again. You won't have to start the scene all over. You just bring in only that part you corrected, and you will delete the old one and replace it with the new one. Take for instance, I want to elevate this particular point, and as you can see, this is a grass, and I want to elevate this point, this swimming pool area. I want to make it higher. So the way I can do it is I will go to Revit, work on it, carry this side up, model this side so that this side will go up, then I will now delete this one and bring in that one, and the process will be very easy. And see how I will do it now. So I am going to take note of all the things that I'm going to bring in. If it means carrying a pen and write it down so that I will not forget. So these are the things I will bring in. I am going to delete these curves here, and that means I'm going to bring in new curve. I'm going to bring in new curve so that this one will be deleted. Then I am going to bring in new swimming pool. I am going to bring in grass, which I name as lawn. My grass is lawn. I'm going to bring in that one. Then I am going to create a retaining wall here, and that means I'm no longer going to have caps here. So that means I will bring in retaining wall as well. Then I will also bring in coping. I already have coping in the scene already. I have coping in the scene, so I'm going to replace all the coping. So these are the things I'm going to bring in now. So I have already noted them. I am going to close this scene. I'll reset this scene. Okay, now I am going to import. I've already made that correction, so I will import that new scene I've created and save it as a new file. Okay, this is the one I corrected, and I will bring it in, and I will use combine by material, attach this file. Okay, now this is the new scene. I'm going to delete this camera. Okay, this is the new scene. So and you can see the correction I made. These are the correction I have made. I've brought in retaining wall. Okay, the name is Caps 1. And this is the grass I will bring in, which is lawn. Then I have coping here. which I'm also going to bring in. Then I have my swimming pool here. I'm going to bring in swimming pool as well. So these are the things I'm going to bring in. Then I am going to save this file as another name. Let's see. We'll go 00. Oh, okay, so I'm going to reset this scene now. You want to reset? Yes. Then I am going to open the previous scene, which was Ugochukwu 2. This is a scene I want to correct now. This is my former scene that I want to correct. So I'm going to bring in, I'm going to import all those stuff I've corrected now. So I will go to application menu and go to import. So instead of link FBS now, I'm going to use merge. Then I am going to select that file. I'll click open. Then these are the materials I'm going to, this is where I'm going to select the material I want to import. So I'll look for all those materials I need to import. I need to import lawn, then caps. You remember this one was my retaining wall, the name for my retaining wall. I didn't name it as retaining wall in Revit. It was an oversight, but it's not bad. Okay, then lawn. Then I'm also going to bring in swimming pool. Where's my swimming pool? Okay. I think these are what I needed. These are the four things I need. So I'm going to hit OK. Now it will ask me to merge, skip, delete. So I'm going to delete old ones. I'll hit delete. Then it's asking me for the material. I will use scene material. Okay, now it has replaced all those ones, so I can now apply my material afresh. Let me apply my material now and see. You, it will be obvious now. This is, I'll select my grass and apply the material. Then I'll select my caps, then apply my material. You can see that caps is now replaced. That cap is no longer here again. It's now replaced. Okay. Then it's a question of getting another material for my retaining wall. Let's say I want to use this stone for my retaining wall. And I'm going to apply that stone to my retaining wall. Ah, that's one I forgot to bring in coping. I forgot to bring in coping. So I'm going to bring in coping now. Let me go and bring in coping. I'll hit import, merge, then select that material, that file again. Then I'm going to select coping. Where is my coping? Okay, this is coping. Then I'm going to delete old ones. Okay, you can see it has come. All right. Okay, there's another thing I want to correct. This one is not supposed to be here. This belt is not supposed to be here. So there are ways you can correct it. It is either you use delete mesh. But if it is available in other part of the drawing and you use delete mesh, it will be, all those parts will be deleted. So if you don't want to delete every part, if it is only this particular one you want to delete, then I'm going to go to this modify mode. You may not see all this. if you don't know how to bring in this, you will not see all this. So this is how you toggle it. This is how you bring it in. You check this show button, then you also check this. Assuming I uncheck this show button, then you are not going to see that stuff. So this is how your one may be. So if you want to show all those hidden tools, you will click on this configure modify set and click show button, then you now see all this. So if I select that one, I can now edit poly. If I edit poly, then I will select element so that I will only delete this particular one, so that it is only this one that will be deleted. So I'm going to use delete mesh, and my shortcut key for delete mesh is Shift D. So it has been deleted. As simple as that. Okay, thank you for watching this video, and I hope to see you in my next video. Bye. Hello, what's up today? In this video, I want to show you how to make corrections easily. In 3ds Max. Now, sometimes you import FBS file from Revit or SketchUp, and all of a sudden you've forgotten to correct something. Maybe there's something that was omitted, or you decide to want to create a new model part. So this is what this video will show you. Now, there are two ways you can go about it. If you know how to model in 3ds Max, and what you have to model is not much, then you can simply model it in 3ds Max. But if you don't know how to model in 3ds Max, then you can go back to your Revit, you work on it, and you are going to bring it in here. Only that part that you corrected is what you are going to bring in here. So you will not have to start afresh again. You won't have to start the scene all over. You just bring in only that part you corrected, and you will delete the old one and replace it with the new one. Take for instance, I want to elevate this particular point. And as you can see, this is a grass, and I want to elevate this point, this swimming pool area. I want to make it higher. So the way I can do it is, I will go to Revit, work on it, carry this side up, model this side so that this side will go up, then I will now delete this one and bring in that one, and the process will be very easy. And see how I will do it now. So I am going to take note of all the things that I'm going to bring in. If it means carrying a pen and write it down so that I will not forget. So these are the things I will bring in. I am going to delete these curves here. And that means I'm going to bring in new curve. I'm going to bring in new curve so that this one will be deleted. Then I am going to bring in new swimming pool. I am going to bring in grass, which I name as lawn. My grass is lawn. I'm going to bring in that one. Then I am going to create a retaining wall here. That means I'm no longer going to have caps here. So that means I will bring in retaining wall as well. Then I will also bring in coping. I already have coping in the scene already. I have coping in the scene. So I'm going to replace all the coping. So these are the things that I'm going to bring in now. So I have already noted them. I am going to close this scene. I'll reset this scene. Okay, now I am going to import, I've already made that correction, so I will import that new scene I've created and save it as a new file. Okay, this is the one I corrected, and I will bring it in, and I will use combine by material, attach this file. Okay, now this is the new scene. I'm going to delete this camera. Okay, this is the new scene. So and you can see the correction I made. These are the correction I have made. I've brought in retaining wall. Okay. The name is Kerbs 1, and this is the grass I will bring in, which is lawn. Then I have coping here, which I'm also going to bring in. Then I have my swimming pool here. I'm going to bring in swimming pool as well. So these are the things I'm going to bring in. Then I am going to save this file as another name. Let's say Ugo 00. Okay, so I am going to reset this scene now. You want to reset? Yes. Then I am going to open the previous scene, which was Ugochukwu 2. Okay, this is the new scene. This is the scene I want to correct now. This is my former scene that I want to correct. So I'm going to import all those stuff I've corrected now. So I will go to application menu and go to import. So instead of link FBS now, I'm going to use merge. Then I am going to select that file. I'll click open. Then these are the materials this is where I'm going to select the material I want to import. So I'll look for all those materials I need to import. I need to import lawn. Then caps. You remember this one was my retaining wall, the name for my retaining wall. I didn't name it as retaining wall in Revit. It was an oversight, but it's not bad. Okay, then lawn. Then I'm also going to bring in swimming pool. Where's my swimming pool? Okay, I think these are what I needed. These are the four things I need. So I'm going to hit OK. Now it will ask me to merge, skip, delete. So I'm going to delete old ones. I'll hit delete. Then it's asking me for the material. I will use scene material. Okay, now it has replaced all those ones. So I can now apply my material afresh. Let me apply my material now and see you. It will be obvious now. This is, I'll select my grass and apply the material. Then I'll select my caps, then apply my material. You can see that caps is now replaced. That cap is no longer here again. It's now replaced. Okay. Then it's a question of getting another material for my retaining wall. Let's say I want to use this stone for my retaining wall. And I'm going to apply that stone to my retaining wall. I forgot to bring in coping. So I'm going to bring in coping now. Let me go and bring in coping. I'll hit import, merge, then select that material, that file again. Then I'm going to select coping. Where is my coping? Okay, this is coping. Then I'm going to delete old ones. Okay, you can see it has come. Alright. Okay, there's another thing I want to correct. This one is not supposed to be here. This belt is not supposed to be here. So there are ways you can correct it. It is either you use delete mesh. But if it is available in other part of the drawing and you use delete mesh, it will be, all those parts will be deleted. So if you don't want to delete every part, if it is only this particular one you want to delete, then I'm going to go to this modify mode. You may not see all this. If you don't know how to bring in this, you will not see all this. So this is how you toggle it. This is how you bring it in. You check this show button, then you also check this. Assuming I uncheck this show button, then you are not going to see that stuff. So this is how your wall may be. So if you want to show all those hidden tools, you will click on this configure modify set and click show button. Then you now see all this. So if I select that one, I can now edit poly. If I edit poly, then I will select element so that I will only delete this particular one, so that it is only this one that will be deleted. Okay, there's another one that I don't want, and this is this belt. So I'm going to use delete mesh, and my shortcut key for delete mesh is Shift D. So it has been deleted. As simple as that. Okay, thank you for watching this video, and I hope to see you in my next video. Bye.